Yes, tea exports have risen about 3% in the first 2 months of 2018 from a year ago, following an increase in the prices of Sri Lankan and Kenyan teas that actually made Indian tea more competitive in the global market. Is this uptrend likely to continue? And with a favorable monsoon forecast, how are tea manufacturers expecting the current year to pan out? Let's get a management view from Kamal Baheti, the Chief Financial Officer at Mcleod Russel. Good morning, Mr. Baheti. Thank you very much for joining us. If you could tell us what's happening with the tea prices, both India and globally, since the start of 2018.
See, the tea season starts particularly in North India sometime middle of March. The production starts for the new season. And the teas actually come in the middle of April for sales. Although it is a little lower quantities which come, but we have got a very good trend to start with. The new season teas are trending around 20 to 25 rupees higher than last year. And this is on the backdrop, which you rightly said, is that last year there had been pretty good exports out of India. The overall crop had been similar. In the last few weeks of the last season, we did not have much cheese to be sold in the auctions. It means that we were going a little over on the inventories. So going by the lower inventories, very good exports happening, international markets being very good. Opening level did suggest that there are going to be change in the cycle in the tea prices. And opening level had been 20-25 rupees per kg higher. But I think it is too early to really take a full call on the year because these quantities are very small. It may take a couple of weeks before we really get into the real trend on the tea prices.
Sir, according to an earlier brokerage report, for calendar year 2018, Kenyan tea production is expected at about 450 million kgs on account of good weather conditions. So what would that really mean for global tea price trends, at least for the upcoming, the ongoing tea year now?
No, Kenya did produce for the calendar year 2016 around 470 million kilograms of kg. Last year, they dropped by 35-40 million kilograms because of the poor weather. The weather is better, they may go back to 450-460 million. But it is not going to change the overall supply into the world markets in the sense that these kind of supplies were there even 2 years back. Last year, the prices have gone up in Kenya. And also for African prices, the prices were up by 15-20%. And even with a little improvement in the overall crop in Kenya because of the better weather as compared to last year, the prices are similar to last year. So they are not dropping after an increase of 15-20% last year. So I think if we really look at the global trend, looking at the overall production pattern, I think we will look at very similar production of last 2 years average, both in Kenya and Sri Lanka. And India will also be looking at similar kind of a production. So if the production level continues to be the similar, with the growth in the consumption in India, we believe it is growing by around 3-3.5% per annum. The shortages will be felt more and more as we go along. So I think whether there is a recovery in the crop in Kenya or not, the global prices as well as the Indian prices should really be firm for the year 2018-19. But as I said, that this is just the beginning of the season. We have seen good price trend for the opening level. We have to really get the confirmation as we go along.
So can you shed some light on what your expectations may be when it comes to the revision of wage agreements and what that can mean for Mcleod Russel?
See, this is for the entire industry. The new wage agreement is due from 1st of January 2018. The negotiations are on. I would not like to hazard any guess, but what we had seen in the previous agreements, I think the similar trend should also be there. And there are some discussion which is on. So I think we have to wait for a couple of months before we really get into what will be the impact. But more impactful, I think, whatever may be the increase will be across the board in the tea industry. I think prices will be need to go up much more than that to really compensate not only for the cost increase, but because the cost has increased over the last 3-4 years also and the prices have not gone up. So I think the price increase will take care of this. But we have to wait for the final negotiations to happen before we can comment on the wages.